Hi, it's Jill here from St. Matthew's in Edgeley. We're going to try and make some flatbread together this afternoon. It's, of course, coronavirus time, so you might not be able to get the ingredients, but I'm hoping that you might have some plain flour stuffed away at the back of the cupboard somewhere. So, here we go. First of all, the ingredients. So, we're going to have some plain flour, 250 grams. Into the bowl, and then a tablespoon of baking powder that goes in, half a teaspoon of salt, so a little pinch really, half a cup or 120 millilitres of water, quarter of a cup or 60 millilitres of milk, and 2 tablespoons of olive oil. Ooh, that's a bit gloopy. So we're going to make flatbread because on Thursday, we remember Jesus and his disciples having a last meal together. We call it the Last Supper. And at that meal, they had flatbread, and wine, amongst other things. It was a Passover meal. Perhaps my cameraman can just come in here to the bowl for a minute. You can see we're just mixing all the ingredients together in the bowl. I've actually halved my mixture. There we go. Lovely. You can zoom out again now. Thank you very much. So, we've got our dough. A little bit sticky, so I'm going to add a little bit more plain flour, and I'm going to add some plain flour to my board. I'm going to roll it out in a minute. You can learn about the original Passover meal in the book of Exodus in the Bible, but you can find story of the Last Supper in the Gospels, there in the New Testament. Ooh, it's quite sticky. Now we're going to divide the dough. You divide the full mixture into 8 portions. So I've halved my mixture, so I'm going to have 4. Ooh, it is sticky. This is the good bit. So just use a cloth to my hands there. And there's the rolling pin. And roll out the flat bread. Oh, it's looking right. You stay there, I'll be back in a moment. There's my baking tray. You can line the baking tray with baking parchment, or I've got one of those baking sheets, and on it goes. And you'll end up with, if you do the whole mixture, you'll end up with 8 of those, or I'm going to end up with half the mixture with 4 of those. I'll show you what I made earlier. Here we go. So at the Last Supper, Jesus broke the bread and he shared it with his friends, his disciples, and he told them to do this when he'd gone. Do it to remember him. And if you go to any Christian church, you'll find people breaking and sharing bread at the communion. So maybe you'd like to have a go at making some flatbread and reading about the story of the Last Supper, Jesus and his disciples, as we commemorate it this week in Holy Week. Thanks for listening, and tune in to any of St. Matthew's YouTube channel productions, or follow us on our St. Matthew's Church Edgeley Facebook page. Say cheerio for now. Bye bye.